Shingles, medically known as herpes zoster, is a viral infection characterized by a painful rash with blisters. It is caused by the varicella-zoster virus, which also causes chickenpox. After a person recovers from chickenpox, the virus remains dormant in the nerve tissues near the spinal cord and brain. Years later, the virus can reactivate, leading to shingles. Shingles typically begins with a painful rash that may be preceded by symptoms such as pain, often described as a burning, tingling, or shooting pain, which can be intense. This pain may occur before the rash appears and can persist throughout the duration of the outbreak. A red, blotchy rash usually appears a few days after the pain begins. The rash typically develops into clusters of fluid-filled blisters. These blisters can break open, crust over, and eventually heal. The affected area may itch, especially as the rash heals. The skin around the rash may be sensitive to touch or experience heightened sensitivity. Some individuals may experience symptoms similar to the flu, including fever, headache, fatigue, and general malaise. In some cases, shingles can cause nerve-related symptoms such as numbness, tingling, or a feeling of pins and needles in the affected area. Direct contact with fluid from shingles blisters can transmit the virus to others, causing chickenpox in those who haven't had it. Shingles is more common in older adults, particularly those over the age of 50. As people age, their immune system may weaken, making them more susceptible to the reactivation of the virus. Individuals with weakened immune systems due to conditions such as HIV/AIDS, cancer, or certain medications such as corticosteroids or immunosuppressants are at higher risk. High levels of stress or trauma can weaken the immune system, increasing the likelihood of shingles. Certain medical conditions, such as diabetes, autoimmune diseases, or chronic illnesses, can increase the risk of developing shingles. Trauma or surgery in an area of the body can sometimes trigger the reactivation of the varicella-zoster virus, leading to shingles. Some medications, such as chemotherapy drugs or long-term steroid use, can increase the risk of shingles by weakening the immune system. Pregnant women may have a higher risk of developing shingles due to changes in their immune system. Shingles is typically diagnosed based on its characteristic symptoms and physical examination by a healthcare professional. Your healthcare provider will ask about your symptoms, including any pain, rash, or other sensations you may be experiencing. They will also inquire about your medical history, including whether you've had chickenpox in the past. Your healthcare provider will examine the rash and affected area to look for characteristic signs of shingles, such as a red blistering rash that typically follows a specific pattern along a nerve pathway. In some cases, a sample of fluid from a blister may be collected and tested in a laboratory to confirm the presence of the varicella-zoster virus. A Zank smear involves scraping cells from the base of a blister and examining them under a microscope to look for evidence of the varicella-zoster virus. Blood tests may be performed to detect antibodies to the varicella-zoster virus, which can help confirm a diagnosis of shingles. The goals of treatment are to shorten the duration of the outbreak, alleviate pain and discomfort, and reduce the risk of complications. Prescription antiviral drugs such as acyclovir, valacyclovir, or famciclovir are commonly used to treat shingles. These medications work by stopping the replication of the varicella-zoster virus, which can help reduce the severity and duration of the outbreak if started early in the course of the illness. Pain management is an essential part of shingles treatment, as the condition can cause significant discomfort. Over-the-counter pain relievers, such as ibuprofen or acetaminophen, may help relieve mild to moderate pain. In some cases, prescription pain medications or topical treatments, such as lidocaine patches, may be recommended for more severe pain. Antihistamines or topical creams containing calamine or colloidal oatmeal may help relieve itching associated with the shingles rash. Applying cool, moist compresses to the affected area can help soothe the rash and reduce itching. It's important to keep the rash clean and dry to prevent infection. Avoid scratching or picking at the rash, as this can lead to further irritation and increase the risk of complications. Getting plenty of rest and avoiding stress can help support the immune system and promote healing. In some cases, shingles can cause persistent nerve pain even after the rash has healed, a condition known as postherpetic neuralgia. Medications such as gabapentin, pregabalin, or tricyclic antidepressants may be prescribed to help manage this type of pain. Complications of shingles include postherpetic neuralgia, which is a persistent nerve pain after the rash heals. Vision loss. If shingles occurs in or around the eye, also known as herpes, zoster ophthalmicus. Neurological problems, such as encephalitis or facial paralysis. Skin infections from scratching the blisters. Rarely, pneumonia or other serious complications, especially in individuals with weakened immune systems. Vaccination is the most effective way to prevent shingles. The shingles vaccine, usually a two-dose series, is recommended for adults aged 50 and older. Vaccination can also reduce the risk of postherpetic neuralgia and other complications. Good hygiene practices, such as washing hands frequently and avoiding close contact with individuals who have active shingles, can help prevent transmission of the virus. Early treatment of chickenpox in children and prompt treatment of shingles can also help reduce the risk of complications. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more informative content. Stay tuned for our next video.